हेलो एवरीवन, अ वेरी वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. एम आई विजिबल? एम आई ऑडिबल? गिव मी अ मिनट टू कंफर्म. इफ आई एम विजिबल ऑडिबल आई विल स्टार्ट द सेशन एट. गिव मी अ मिनट टू कंफर्म. इट विल हार्डली टेक अ मिनट टू कंफर्म. यस, आई गेस इट्स वर्किंग. यस, सो वेरी वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. आई एम डॉक्टर प्रियंका सचदेव हियर एंड टुडे आई एम हियर टू टीच यू अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फ्रॉम माइक्रोबायोलॉजी ऑन द ह्यूज डिमांड ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स. So I am starting virology today. I am starting virology today. So today I am going to take a general virology portion. In the general virology portion, I will start with classification and structure of viruses and maybe the replication of virus. So today we are starting with that. So let me start the virology. It's going to be a super duper important topic for your university exams of second prof, as well as many 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 MCQs come from the classification of the viruses. Students always have confusion in the classification of the viruses, right? So let me start. So before starting the classification and the structure and general properties of the virus, let me tell you something which is common for the all the viruses. All the viruses are intracellular infective agents. Virus cannot do the replication outside the host cell. Virus can replicate only inside the host cell. The host cell can be human, can be animal. So it is the smallest obligate intracellular infective agent. They contain nucleic acid, but either they contain DNA or RNA, never both. It is a very important point based on which we will classify the viruses, either DNA viruses or RNA viruses, but never both. So if one virus is there, whether the virus will contain DNA or the virus will contain RNA, but virus will not contain both DNA and RNA. Humans have both, bacteria have both, but virus have one of them, either DNA or RNA. They are resistant to antibiotics, which makes them different from bacteria. Bacteria are sensitive to antibiotics. We can kill the bacteria using antibiotics, but we cannot kill the bacteria using we cannot kill the viruses using antibiotics. They are resistant to antibiotics, but they are sensitive to interferons. So after that, let me tell you a common property. After this, let me tell you the morphology of the virus. Now, one by one, I'm going to discuss the size of the virus, structure of the virus, symmetry of the virus, shape of the virus. In the structure, I will discuss classification also. So this is how the lecture will go today. Let me start with the size of the virus. Can anyone tell me what is the unit? What is the size of the virus? So size of the virus is in nanometer. You know what is nano? Nanometer is 10 to the power minus 9. That is the size of the virus. What is the size of the bacteria? The size of the bacteria is micrometer. You know what is micrometer? 10 to the power minus 6 is micrometer. You got my point? Now you can compare the size of the bacteria and the size of the virus. So of course, viruses are 1000 times smaller than bacteria. Can I say this is 10 to the power minus 6, this is 10 to the power minus 9? So can I say the viruses are 1000 times smaller than bacteria, right? Yes, so it is true. So if I use a light microscope, which we have in our laboratory, you all have light microscope in your laboratory. In the light microscope, the maximum magnification can be done is micrometer. So in light microscope, we can see the bacteria, but in light microscope, we cannot see the virus. We cannot see the virus on a light microscope. If you want to see the virus, you have to use a microscope with greater magnification, that is electron microscope. So these are the basics you should know. Okay. So that is regarding size. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Osama, Aditya, Diksha, Obed, everyone. Are you people there? You got the size. So size of the virus is nanometer, which is 1000 times smaller than bacteria. The size of the bacteria is micrometer. So that is the size. Now you tell me, I'm asking you six questions. Six questions, six answers. Can you tell me smallest virus? Smallest overall. Okay. Tell me smallest DNA virus. Tell me smallest RNA virus. And tell me smallest overall. Overall from the DNA and RNA overall. The three questions. The same three questions with the largest. Can you tell me largest DNA virus? Can you tell me largest RNA virus? And can you tell me largest overall virus? So three questions on the largest. So there are six MCQs from the size which usually asked in your exam. This is MCQs, the six MCQs. So let me tell you the six answers. Six questions, six answers. Okay? Ab mazay ki baat ye hai ki everything, all six start from P. So students always have confusion which P, which P. So is it Parvo, is it Picorna, it is Papova, which P? It is P, everything is P. So P is very confusing. All the P named virus are very confusing in virology. So make your concepts clear now. Let me first talk about the DNA viruses. DNA viruses. We are having six DNA viruses. I will tell you the classification. Out of the six, the smallest is parvo. Learn ki parvo is the smallest one. Sabse chota hai parvo. And the largest is the pox. Largest is the pox. Both are DNA. I will show you this diagram. So these are the six DNA viruses in front of you. See, I will give you a mnemonic. Don't worry. Don't read all six. I will give you a mnemonic to learn the six DNA viruses. There are only six DNA viruses in the world. All six are shown to you in this image. Can you see? They are arranged in decreasing size. Decreasing size, they are arranged. Can you see which is the largest? I can see pox virus. This one is the largest one. I can see size wise. And if going further, can you see which is the smallest? I can see parvovirus. It is very small as compared to pox virus. Pox virus is the large virus, largest DNA virus. It is as big, so we can see it only virus, or which can be seen on light microscope also. I have told you viruses cannot be seen on light microscope, but pox virus is such a large virus, we can see it on light microscope also. So again, important MCQ, the only virus which can be seen on light microscope, answer is pox virus, because it is very large. You got my point? Otherwise, viruses are seen on electron microscope, not on light microscope. So DNA ki baat khatam hui. Among DNA, the smallest is parvo and the largest is pox. We are having six DNA viruses. One is smallest, one is largest. Theek hai? And four are intermediate. Ye four are intermediate, we will learn them later on. Coming on RNA. Chalo, DNA ho gaya, toh ab RNA ki baat karo. How many RNA viruses are there? There are 15 families of RNA viruses. There are 6 family of DNA. DNA viruses have only 6 family. But among the RNA, there are 15. The important one are shown here. Here not all 15 are shown, but the important one are shown. Again, they are arranged in decreasing size, in decreasing manner, decreasing order. You can see which is the largest. I can see paramyxo. Paramyxo, myxo ka bada bhai hai. Orthomyxo ka bada bhai, paramyxo. So this one is the largest RNA. Largest RNA. And smallest is picorna. You know pico ka matlab hota hai? Chota. Pico. Pico is a word which means smallest. So picorna, pico is the smallest. You got my point? So this one is the smallest. So picorna and paramyxo. So picorna is the smallest one and paramyxo is the largest one. You got my point? Picorna and paramyxo. So can you tell me four things now? I am asking you, among the DNA, which is smallest, which is largest? Who will tell me the two answers, smallest and largest? And among the RNA, who is smallest, who is largest? Who is smallest, who is largest? Who will give me the answer? Let me give you a clue. Everything starts with P. Tell me the full form. Konsa P? Okay, let me ask smallest DNA. Who will answer? Aditya. Smallest DNA? Yes, very good, Aditya. It's parvo. Who is the largest DNA? Who will tell me the largest DNA? Priyanshi, Yogita, Osama. Who will tell me largest DNA? Yes, largest DNA is pox. Very good. The largest DNA is pox. Very, very good. Now coming on the smallest RNA. Who will tell me the smallest RNA? Smallest RNA kaunsa hai? Among RNA, which is the smallest? I'm asking smallest, not paramyxo, Yogita. No, no, no. Smallest is picorna. Pico ka matlab chota. Picorna. Pico ka matlab chota. Aur largest one is paramyxo. Para matlab bada bhai. Myxo ka bada bhai, paramyxo. So learn it is largest. Bada bhai hai na, paramyxo. So learn like that. Theek hai. The four answers are in front of you and you all are genius. You all are right. Now we are having two smallest. This is also smallest. This is also smallest. Among the two smallest, which is more smaller? Which is overall smallest? Picorna is smallest among RNA and parvo is smallest among DNA. Lekin chota, chota, chote mein bhi chota kaun? Sabse chota kaun? So DNA ka sabse chota parvo, RNA ka sabse chota picorna, lekin sabse chota is parvo, the smallest one. So parvo is overall smallest also. Theek hai? Let's talk about the largest. Among DNA, largest is pox. Among RNA, largest is paramyxo. Lekin tell me overall. But ye bhi bada, ye bhi bada. Lekin bade mein bada, sabse bada kaun? So again, overall mein answer will be pox. You got my point? So the overall smallest and overall largest are same as that of DNA. You got my point? So totally, finally, we have learned six questions. What six questions? Among the DNA, among the RNA and among the overall. Overall are same as that of DNA. The smallest, the largest, the smallest, the largest. The smallest and the largest. You should not have any confusion. So among DNA, the smallest is parvo and among DNA, the largest is pox. The same are with overall. Overall may be smallest is parvo like DNA and largest is pox. So you can learn that DNA and overall, the answers are same. But answers are different for RNA. In the RNA, the smallest one is picorna and the largest one is paramyxo. So, six questions, six answers are clear in front of you without any confusion. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Shall I proceed ahead? If you got the smallest and the largest, if you got it, so let me proceed ahead. Let me tell you the structure of virus. Now, let's start the structure of virus. The structure of virus. In all virus, one thing is common. They all have nucleic acid in the center. Let me draw. The nucleic acid can be DNA, can be RNA, never both. If one virus is having DNA, it cannot have RNA. If one virus is having RNA, it cannot have DNA. It is a rule. So nucleic acid is present in all, but either DNA or RNA, based on which we will classify the virus. Theek hai? Based on which. And it is surrounded by a protein capsid. This is the protein capsid. The capsid is made up of protein. It is a polymer. It is made up of monomers. The monomer is known as capsomer. The monomers are known as capsomer because of which a polymer is formed. The polymer is known as capsid and it is protein in nature. Ye protein ka bana hua hai. Iska monomer hai capsomer aur polymer ko kehte hain capsid. It is present in all virus by default. It is present. So two things are present in all virus. What two things? Number one, nucleic acid, which can be DNA or RNA but never both. ठीक है एंड नंबर टू इज कैप्सोमर विच इज प्रोटीन एंड इट इज अ पॉलीमर मेड अप ऑफ कैप्सोमर नंबर थ्री सम वायरसेस हैव इनवलप सम डू नॉट हैव इनवलप इट इज नॉट अ कंपलसरी थिंग सो इनवलप कैन बी प्रेजेंट कैन बी एब्सेंट बट न्यूक्लिक एसिड एंड कैप्सिड इज प्रेजेंट इन ऑल समझ में आया क्या समझ में आया सो वॉट आई एम सीइंग सी हियर आई हैव ड्रॉन टू वायरसेस फॉर यू टू शो यू द टू टाइप्स सो इन द फर्स्ट वायरस दिस वन We are having nucleic acid at the center, which is surrounded by the capsid, capsomer. In the second virus, we are having nucleic acid, we are having capsid, but it is surrounded by envelope also. It is having envelope also. So this virus is non-enveloped, this virus is enveloped. You got my point? So there are few non-enveloped virus which don't have envelope, few enveloped virus which have envelope. So I will classify the virus now, which are DNA, six are DNA. Among the six, how many enveloped, how many non-enveloped? Among the RNA, how many RNA? We are having 15 RNA. Among the 15 RNA, how many enveloped, how many non-enveloped? So I will give you mnemonics for everything. Don't worry. Let me proceed ahead. Are you people with me? Sabka thumbs up chahiye. Osama, Aditya, Yogita, Priyanshi. Sab log ho mere saath? Osama. Right, everyone is here. Shall I proceed ahead? So let me classify the virus. We classify the virus based on nucleic acid. See, in the center we are having red color nucleic acid which is present in all virus. So the virus which is having DNA as a nucleic acid are known as DNA virus. The virus which is having RNA as a nucleic acid are RNA virus. I have told you there are 6 families, there are 15 families. Learn the name of the family. Family ke andar multiple members hain. Multiple members are there. So among the 6 families, multiple members are there. Among the total 15 families, multiple. So learn the name of the families first. Then we will try to learn the name of the members. Let's start DNA viruses. So see, the DNA viruses are in front of you. Let me give you a mnemonic for that. Mnemonic is double H A triple P. Double H A triple P you can learn like happy, happy. Or double H A triple P. H2AP3. You can learn like that, whatever you learn. So these are the 6 DNA viruses. Let me tell you the full form. There are 2 H. What are the 2 H? Herpes. Herpes and hepatina. Herpes and hepatina. There are various types of herpes. When I will teach you the virology in detail, there are total 8 herpes. I will teach you all members. Unke andar 8 tarah ke hain. Herpes is the name of the family. Member kitne hain uski family mein? 8 member hain. Hame 8 ho padhne hain detail mein. Lekin some other day. Right? Hepatina have only one member, hepatitis B virus. Only one member. So, yahan pe sirf ek hi member hai. Try to learn the members also in family. So, the 2 H are over. Herpes and hepatina. These are the name of the families which are having multiple members inside them. You got my point? EBV, CMV, HSV1, HSV2, Varicella zoster. These are all family ke members. Hai. Herpes and hepatina. We are done with 2. A stands for adeno. Having only one member adeno. Adeno mein ek hi member hai adeno. Adenoviridae, adenovirus. Adenoviridae is the name of the family. Uske andar virus hai adeno. Right? So adeno, A. Now triple P is very confusing. So 1 P is smallest, 1 is largest. Batao DNA mein smallest kaun tha, largest kaun tha? Smallest ki baat karo, to it is parvo. Parvovirus, the smallest one. Or largest one, the pox. Largest is the pox. So one is parvo, one is pox, smallest and largest. Ek teesra P baj gaya. The third PV is papova. So let me try to say the full form. Who will help me? So say double H A triple P. double H A triple P. This is the mnemonic. Can you help me with the full form, with the family? Family ka to naam bolo, uske andar ki members hum baad mein learn karenge. Learn the name of the families. The six DNA families having multiple members inside them. Can you help me? Yogita is trying. Very good, Yogita. So it is Hippadna. Hippadna. Very good. Hippadna. The second H is herpes. Second is herpes. Hippadna viridi, herpes viridi. A for adeno. Yes, Osama. Very good. A for adeno. The 2P. Out of the three, do to ek smallest, ek largest le lo. Teen mein se ek smallest le lo, ek largest le lo. To do to nipad jayenge. To ek le lo pox, ek le lo parvo. और एक जो बच गया वो याद कर लो. इट इज पैपोवा. पैपोवा में तीन वायरसेस होते हैं, तो कॉम्बिनेशन इज पैपोवा. ठीक है, पैपोवा. तो टोटल सिक्स डीएनए वायरसेस आर देयर. आई गेस एवरीवन इज एबल टू लर्न द नेम ऑफ द सिक्स फैमिलीज. उसके अंदर के मल्टीपल मेंबर्स वी विल ट्राई टू लर्न व्हेन वी विल सी इंडिविजुअल फैमिली. सो दैट इज द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द डीएनए वायरसेस. ठीक है, चलो इन सब में से ये सिक्स डीएनए वायरसेस आर इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. व्हिच इज द स्मॉलेस्ट, व्हिच इज द लार्जेस्ट? We all know that parvo is smallest. हमने पहले ही देख लिया है. And we all know the pox is the largest. ठीक है, ये question तो सबको आता है. और overall में भी this is smallest DNA also, smallest overall also. This is largest DNA also and largest overall also. ये तो हमें सबको पता है. Everyone knows it. मैंने पहले ही बता दिया है. My next question. We know these all are DNA viruses. Of course, मैं DNA viruses ही पढ़ा रही हूँ. These all are DNA viruses. But you tell me whether these are double-stranded DNA or single-stranded DNA. Which among them are double-stranded and which among them are single-stranded? My next question. समझ में आ रहा है क्या मैं क्या पूछ रही हूँ? सबके सब DNA हैं. छह के छह DNA viruses हैं. All of them are DNA. We are studying the classification of DNA. लेकिन मुझे बताओ double-stranded DNA है कि single और कौन सा क्या है? तो usually DNA जो होता है ना, learn like this. जो usually DNA होता है वो double-stranded होता है. We know ना, DNA is usually double-stranded. Single-stranded DNA is there but rare. And usually RNA is single-stranded. Double-stranded RNA is rare. We know that. So all of them are double-stranded DNA. Because double-stranded DNA is common. Except smallest parvo. Parvo exception mein jayega, which is having single-stranded DNA. Learn like that ki parvo itna chota hai na. It is very small. It cannot accommodate double-stranded DNA. To usne bola mujhe single-stranded hi de do. Maine aise learn kiya to main kabhi nahi bhulti. You got my point? You understand Hindi? Yes. So tell me what we have learned. Regarding DNA viruses, we have finished something. The six DNA viruses we know. So double H, A, triple P. Among the triple P, one is pox, one is parvo, and one is papova. You know baki ke full form. Now we have learned this one is largest, this one is smallest. We have learned all have double-stranded DNA except parvo, which is having single-stranded DNA. Rest all have double-stranded. Abhi tak ka summary ye hai. You got my point? Abhi tak ka, this is the summary. I want thumbs up from everyone till now. So all DNA viruses have double-stranded DNA except parvo, which is single-stranded DNA. We have learned that this exception is very important. See the diagram. See the diagram. You can see the six DNA viruses. So in the decreasing size, you can see the largest, you can see the smallest. That's it. Theek hai, aage badhenge. RNA viruses. Come on, RNA viruses. How many RNA viruses are there? Kitni families hoti hain? 15. So I will give you a mnemonic. What is the mnemonic? The mnemonic is ABCD. ABCD for, F-O-R for. ABCD for TPH. TPH learn kar lo, PTH kar lo, kuch bhi. TPH you can learn like TPH ko kya bana de? Tweet per hour. We can make like that. Tweet per hour. So these are the 15 families of the RNA viruses. Usme se CR2, FR2, RR3 and PR2, right? Or you can learn PTH. Parathormone ko likhte hai na, PTH. So total count, they are 15. Please count them. They are 15. Now let me tell you the full form. Let me try the full form. So here A stands for arena. Theek hai? B stands for bunya. The 2C, one is corona, one is calci. So one is calci, one is corona. Coronavirus and calci. Coronavirus is a RNA virus. We all know that. I guess sabko pata hai ye to. Theek hai? D for delta. D for delta. This one is D. I'm sorry. D for delta. Theek hai? F. There are two F. One is phylo. One is flavi. Flavi one and phylo one. Flavi and phylo. O is orthomyxo. O is orthomyxo. Or one of the P will be paramyxo. Jo baad mein bataungi. There are three R. Very very important. R tino ke tino super duper important hai. The three R. Tino bahut detail mein padhna hai tumhe. Either the long question are going to be on R. R are very important. One is retro. Retro kabhi mat bhulna, HIV virus. One of the R. Second is rhabdo. Rhabdo is rabies. रेबीज इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो एच आई वी इज रिट्रो, रेबीज इज रैपडो, और तीसरा आर इज रियो, रियो रियो वायरस जो कि डायरिया कराता है. सो द थ्री आर, रिट्रो वायरस जिसमें एच आई वी आएगा. इन द रिट्रो वायरस फैमिली इफ यू सी द नेम ऑफ द मेंबर्स, रिट्रो की फैमिली मेंबर्स में देखोगे तो एच आई वी आएगा, राइट. रैपडो की फैमिली मेंबर्स में देखोगे तो रेबीज आएगा, और रियो की फैमिली मेंबर्स में देखोगे तो रियो रोटा वायरस, आई एम सॉरी रोटा वायरस आएगा रियो में. सो दीज वायरसेस आर इंपॉर्टेंट, देयर फैमिलीज आर इंपॉर्टेंट, द थ्री आर. मैं तीनों बहुत डिटेल में पढ़ाती हूँ हमेशा. द नेक्स्ट वायरस टी, टी फॉर टोगा, टी फॉर टोगा, लेट मी सर्च वेयर इज टी, टी फॉर टोगा. द टू पी, एक स्मॉलेस्ट एक लार्जेस्ट, दो पी है ना, एक स्मॉलेस्ट एक लार्जेस्ट है. सो क्या है, पिकोर्ना इज द स्मॉलेस्ट एंड पैरामिक्सो इज द लार्जेस्ट, खत्म. एंड लास्ट इज एच, एच इज हेपे. सो हु विल हेल्प मी विथ द RNA viruses, the 15 RNA viruses. Does anyone try to help me? Please, anyone, please help me. So what is the mnemonic? Try with the mnemonic. It's A, B, C, D, F, O, R, P, T, H, T, P, H, whatever you write, one and the same thing. So let me complete it. There are 2 C, there are 2 F, there are 2 P, but R are 3. So total they are 15 in number. We will try to say the full form once again. A for arena, B for bunya, the 2 C. The 2C, one is Corona, one is Kelsey. D for Delta, D for Delta. The 2F, Philo Flavi, Philo Flavi, Philovirus, Flavivirus. O for Orthomyxo, O for Orthomyxo. R, मैं तीनों बहुत डिटेल में पढ़ाऊंगी, बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है R. One is Retrovirus, that is HIV. One is Rhabdovirus, that is Rabies. और one is Reovirus, that is Rotavirus. तीनों बहुत सुपर डुपर इंपॉर्टेंट है. उसके बाद नेक्स्ट पे आ जाओ, टोगा वायरस. एच फॉर हेपे वायरस. द टू पी आर, वन इज स्मॉलेस्ट वन इज लार्जेस्ट. स्मॉलेस्ट कौन सा होता है, पिकोर्ना, ठीक है, और लार्जेस्ट कौन सा होता है, पैरामिक्सो, पैरामिक्सो इज द लार्जेस्ट. गिव मी अ थम्स अप एवरीवन. सो वी हैव लर्नड दीज आर द नेम्स ऑफ 15, दीज आर द नेम्स ऑफ 15 आरएनए वायरसेस. नाउ व्हिच इज स्मॉलेस्ट व्हिच इज लार्जेस्ट, वी ऑलरेडी नो द टू पी, पिकोर्ना इज द स्मॉलेस्ट एंड पैरामिक्सो इज द लार्जेस्ट, ये तो सबको पता है. नाउ सिंगल स्ट्रैंडेड डबल स्ट्रैंडेड बता दो, ये सारे आरएनए वायरसेस सिंगल हैं कि डबल हैं, कौन सा सिंगल है कौन सा डबल है, दैट इज माय नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर यू. व्हिच अमंग देम इज सिंगल, दे ऑल आर आरएनए, बट व्हिच इज सिंगल स्ट्रैंडेड आरएनए, व्हिच इज डबल स्ट्रैंडेड आरएनए. सो आरएनए वायरसेस आर यूजुअली सिंगल स्ट्रैंडेड, सिंगल स्ट्रैंडेड. सो दे ऑल 15 में से 14 आर सिंगल स्ट्रैंडेड आरएनए वायरसेस. यहां पे एक्सेप्शन में वन ऑफ द आर विल गो इन एक्सेप्शन, दैट इज रियो. रियो इज हैविंग डबल स्ट्रैंडेड आरएनए. Rio is the exception, which is वहां पे Picorna was exception. You got my point? So my point is that among the DNA, among the RNA, among the DNA viruses there are 6, among the RNA there are 15. Among the DNA they all are double stranded DNA. I'm sorry, double stranded DNA except exception में कौन आएगा यहाँ पे? Except is Parvo, which is single stranded DNA, which is single stranded. All the RNA viruses are single-stranded RNA. They all are single-stranded RNA. But except, exception mein kaun jayega? Rio, which is having double-stranded RNA. So you should learn like this. I cannot simplify than this. Ye sab tumhare MCQs bhi hain, tumhare small, short questions bhi hain for the university exam. Everyone give me a thumbs up. You got my point? So we have learned the name of the 15 RNA viruses. We can see which is smallest, which is largest. All RNA viruses are single-stranded. Except Rio, which is double stranded. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Everyone. RNA में एक और चीज important है, है ना? They all are RNA. They all are RNA. But you know, RNA single strand. Mostly they all are single stranded. Except Rio, which is double stranded. ये सिर्फ Rio है. Rio यहाँ पे जाएगा. And remaining all RNA, the remaining 14 are here. They are single stranded. Among them, among the 15 RNA, 4 are segmented. You got my point? Segmented. Segmented means the nucleic acid is like this in multiple segments. Can you see? I have drawn segmented. Multiple segments hain, multiple fragments hain. So which among them are segmented? So 4 among them. 15 mein se 4 segmented hain. Then the mnemonic is BORA. B-O-R-A. BORA. B for bunya. O for orthomyxo. R for rio. R hamesha learn karna. There are 3 R, you will get confused. So yahan pe rio hai. Wahi jo single stranded, jo double stranded hota hai. And A for arena. So BORA is the mnemonic. See, I have marked the BORA for you. I have marked the BORA for you. Can you see? This is B of BORA. This is O of BORA. This is R of BORA. And this is A of BORA. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So we can mark B, O, one of the R, and A, Bora here also. So that is having fragmented, the segmented. Kitne kitne segment hote hain, ye bhi important hai. So in the bunya, there are three segments. The RN is divided into three segments. Ortho mixo mein 8 hain, ye PYQ hai tumhara in the NEET PG. Right? Rio mein 10 to 12 hain, it is also a PYQ. You can check if you don't believe me. And Arena mein only two are there. So these are fragmented, segmented. So we are done with the nucleic acid. You got my point? Give me a thumbs up if you got my point. So what we have learned? We have learned there are two type of viruses. The DNA viruses and the RNA viruses. What are DNA viruses? They are only 6 in number. Double H, A, triple P. You know the full form. I'm not saying the full form. There are 15 RNA viruses. The mnemonic is A, B, C, D, F-O-R-P-T-H. Parathormone. P-T-H. It's like this. You can learn there are 15 in number. Among them, we have already seen which is smallest, which is largest, which is smallest, which is largest. Everything is P. You already know the answers. I'm not saying. All the DNA are double-stranded. Exception mein jayega parvo, which is single-stranded. All the RNA are single-stranded. Exception mein jayega rio, which is double-stranded. I'm right. Theek hai? Iske baad ek aur cheez last padhi RNA mein, four among them. They are the Bora one. They are fragmented. You can learn like B-O-R-A, the Bora. They are fragmented. Fragmentation DNA mein ek mein bhi nahi hota. Lekin among the 15 RNA, 4 are fragmented. You should know their name. So this is the summary till now. This is the summary till now. Let me proceed ahead. Is summary ki baad, aage chalte hain. Let me tell you capsid. So the nucleic acid is surrounded by capsid. The capsid is made up of capsomer. Ye chote chote jo hai na, ye capsomer hai. They all are capsomer and it is making a protein which is known as capsid. Capsid is protein in nature. All viruses have capsid. All viruses have capsid by default. The third thing is the envelope. Some viruses have it, some do not have it. It is not necessary. And envelope is lipoprotein in nature. It is not protein. It is lipoprotein in nature. You got my point? So nucleic acid is present in all, whether DNA or RNA, but one. Capsid is present in all, which is protein in nature made up of capsomer. But envelope, present in some, absent in some. So the one which have it, they are known as enveloped virus. Enveloped virus. And the one which do not have it are known as non-enveloped virus or naked virus. Naked. Naked yani, they do not have clothes over them. They do not have clothes over them. That is naked virus. So non-enveloped or naked virus. So now you tell me, among the DNA, we are having 6 DNA na? We are having 6 DNA. Out of them, how many are enveloped, how many are non-enveloped? You tell me. And among the RNA, we are having 15 RNA. Now, you know the classification. Tum batao, kitne enveloped hain, kitne non-enveloped hain. How many are enveloped, how many are non-enveloped? Who will tell me? So, I will give you the mnemonic of non-enveloped on both sides. The remaining are enveloped. So, you know H-H-A-P-P-P. In me say, I will take 3 here. I will take PAP, P-A-P. The 3. 2P and 1A. So, what 3? 3P में से कौन सा छोड़ दो? POX को छोड़ दो. Leave POX. POX मत लेना. POX को छोड़ के कौन-कौन आ गए? The 2P. One is PARVO. One is PEPOVA. PEPOVA. And A for Adeno. These three are non-enveloped. The remaining one are enveloped. I'm not writing. कौन-कौन बच गया वो enveloped है. कौन-कौन बच गया? You can see. So it is HHP शायद बच गया. Right? So that is enveloped. So non-enveloped, enveloped is like this. Give me a thumbs up. You got it? Priyanshi, give me a thumbs up. Yogita, Osama. Aditya aur kaun kaun dekh raha hai? You got it? Among the RNA, there are 15 RNA na? So among them only 3 are non-enveloped and 12 are enveloped. So kaun se 3 hai? Jo non-enveloped and naked hai. So the mnemonic for that is PCR. 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 One is PICORNA. P for PICORNA. C for CALCI. Not CORONA. Ye CORONA nahi hai, CALCI hai. And R for RIO. Phir se the 3 R mein se RIO aa raha hai. So the PCR is naked and remaining all, the remaining all are enveloped one. Ab tum bolo ma'am, P mein bahut confusion hota hai. Like P mein ki kaun sa P enveloped hai, kaun sa non-enveloped hai. To jo largest wale hai na, wo enveloped hai. The largest. DNA mein largest kaun tha? POX. So POX is enveloped. POX is enveloped and remaining are non-enveloped. Remaining jo bhi bach gaye. Yahan pe bhi bada kaun hai? Paramyxo. The paramyxo is enveloped. बट यू कैन सी द पिकोर्ना इज नॉन इन्वॉल्व्ड. सो आई हैव लर्न लाइक दैट कि जो बड़ा है द वन लार्जेस्ट उसको हम क्लोथ्स देंगे, उसको हम इन्वॉल्व देंगे. जो छोटे बेबीज होते हैं दे कैन बी नेकेड, तो उसको कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ता है. तो बड़े को हम इन्वॉल्व देंगे, जो छोटे वाले हैं उनको इन्वॉल्व नहीं देंगे. तो स्मॉलेस्ट वाले नॉन इन्वॉल्व्ड हैं, लार्जेस्ट वाले इन्वॉल्व हैं. नाउ यू विल नेवर फॉरगेट. सो ट्राई टू मेक सम कॉन्सेप्ट सम निमोनिक, तुम भूलो नहीं एग्जाम में, वरना इतने सारे पीपी पीपी है ना, यू विल गेट कंफ्यूज हो कौन सा इन्वॉल्व्ड है कौन सा नॉन इन्वॉल्व्ड है, कौन सा स्मॉलेस्ट है कौन सा लार्जेस्ट है, कौन सा डीएनए है कौन सा आरएनए है. तो पी का पूरा खेल है एमसीक्यूज में. यू गॉट माय पॉइंट? सो दैट इज द पॉइंट. सो Among the DNA viruses, these three are naked. By naked, I mean non-enveloped. And among the RNA, these three are naked. See the mnemonic here, PAP. See the mnemonic here, PCR. See, smallest दोनों के naked हैं. यहाँ का smallest parvo भी naked है, यहाँ का smallest picorna भी naked है. दोनों के largest वाले जो भी हैं, वो enveloped हैं. Are you getting it? What I am saying? I am trying to super simplify the things. Now see the six DNA viruses are in front of you. Among the six, if you can notice, I have divided into two columns. Can you see these three have envelope? I can appreciate here. Where is the envelope? You will say, ma'am, envelope दिखाओ. I can see this is the envelope. This is the envelope. But I can't see envelope here. So non-enveloped are pop. Non-enveloped one are pop. See the diagram. Diagram mein bhi dikha diya. Now you should learn. Right. Among the RNA here, the important ones are shown. 15 mein se important are here. Among them, the 12 have envelope. You can notice the envelope on them. Ye sab envelope hai. But among three, these three are non-enveloped. The mnemonic is PCR. The mnemonic is PCR, you know the full form. Give me a thumbs up, come on. So this is the final classification in front of you. Tell me the six DNA viruses. The pehli cheez to naam pata hone chahiye. So you will say, ma'am, HHA, PPP. Among them, you tell me the three are enveloped, the three are non-enveloped. So divide them into 3:3. 3:3. You should know the names. Among HHA, PPP, which are enveloped, which are non-enveloped. The next question, which is smallest among them? Which is largest among them? I guess you know the answer. I am not repeating. Which among them are double-stranded DNA? Which among them are single-stranded DNA? I guess you know the answer. And no need to repeat. ये सारे MCQs DNA के हुए. पहले तो DNA के 6 नाम बताओ. उनमें से कितने involved हैं? कितने non-involved हैं? कौन smallest है? कौन largest है? कौन single-stranded है? कौन double-stranded? इन सब के answer एक जगह करो. खत्म. DNA is finished. Let me tell you the same things on the RNA side. अब RNA कितने होते हैं? How many RNA are there? There are 15 RNA. तो नाम बताओ पहले तो. 15 के नाम ही नहीं पता होते students को. फिर भी exam pass कर लेते हैं. A, B, C, D. ठीक है? A, B, C, D, F, O, R. F-O-R, P-T-H, P-T-H. So this is the 15. Among these 15, now you tell me which are enveloped, which are non-enveloped. You can see these 12 are enveloped. Only 3 are non-enveloped. So the ratio is 12:3. वहाँ पे ratio was 3:3. 3:3, total 6. यहाँ पे 12:3, that is 15. So don't try to learn the 12 names. Try to learn the 3. जो 3 हैं, बचे हुए सारे 12 हैं. So don't learn the 12, learn the 3. It's easy to learn 3 na. 12 learn karne mein mushkil aayegi. 3 yaad kar lo PCR. PCR ko hata do yahan se, jo bhi bach gaya wo enveloped hai. Learn like that. Now the next question here. Which will be the smallest among the 15? Which is the largest among the 15? Which is single-stranded? Which is double-stranded? Ek aur cheez yahan pe aati hai, which is segmented. Segmented extra end. The pore are segmented bora. I guess everyone knows the answer. I'm not repeating the answer, but this is how the classification of the virus goes on. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Yogita, Osama, Aditya, Priyanshi, Amar, samajh mein aaya kya? Koi doubt hai kya? Samajh mein aaya kya? Yes, Yogita, it's Bora. Yes, PCR. So with mnemonics, it will become easy, Yogita. But you should know there are multiple P and multiple R. You will get confused in the exam. So saying the full form is more important. Theek hai? Mnemonics se yaad kar lo, lekin full form bolna hai. तो ये सारी चीजें आपको क्रिस्टल क्लियर याद होनी चाहिए. कौन से डीएनए वायरसेस हैं, नेम दैम, जितने भी हैं इन्वॉल्व्ड कितने हैं, नॉन इन्वॉल्व्ड कितने हैं, जितने भी हैं स्मॉलेस्ट कौन है, लार्जेस्ट कौन है, जितने भी हैं सिंगल स्ट्रैंडेड कौन है, डबल स्ट्रैंडेड कौन है. ये हुई डीएनए की कहानी. द सेम स्टोरी रिपीट विद आरएनए. हाउ मेनी आरएनए आर देयर? देयर आर 15. उसमें से इन्वॉल्व्ड कितने हैं, नॉन इन्वॉल्व्ड कितने हैं, स्मॉलेस्ट कौन है, लार्जेस्ट कौन है, सिंगल स्ट्रैंडेड कौन है, डबल स्ट्रैंडेड कौन है, और फ्रेगमेंटेड कौन है, अलग से ऐड कर लो. सो दिस इज हाउ द स्टोरी एंड्स. दिस इज हाउ आई कैन नॉट सुपर सिंप्लीफाई द थिंग्स देन दिस. This is the most simplified version. I have told you 6 DNA viruses, 3:3. 3 are enveloped, 3 are non-enveloped. You know the mnemonics. Pehle to 6 ka mnemonic batao, unme se 3 enveloped, 3 non-enveloped mnemonic batao. Among the 15 RNA, first tell me the mnemonic kaun se 15 hai. Usme se only the ratio is 12:3. 12 are involved and 3 are non-involved. You should know the names. Smallest, largest here. Single stranded, double stranded, single. मैंने सबकी short tricks बताई हैं आपको. Learn like that, you will never get confused in your exam. Believe me. Whether you are targeting second prop MBBS or whether you are targeting in future your competitive exam. सारे MCQ इसी से आने हैं. Viruses का classification is ultra important. Ultra, ultra, ultra important. You got my point? So with this, let me proceed ahead. If you got it, one more thing I would like to tell you. Give me a minute. Yeah. So we are done with the size. We are done with the structure. Based on the structure, we have done the classification also. Now coming on symmetry of virus. The next point is the symmetry. What do you mean by symmetry? Does anyone know? Symmetry ka matlab kya hota hai? Symmetry ka matlab kya hota hai? What is symmetry? Symmetry kya hota hai? There are three types of symmetry. In the viruses, the three type of symmetries are in front of you. Theek hai? Shape alag hai. Shape is something different. Don't confuse the shape with the symmetry. Theek hai? So the symmetry is something different. Yes. So yes, you can say like that. So there are three type of symmetry. It is icosahedral, it is helical and complex. Ye teen naam hai. Icosahedral kya hoti hai? What is icosahedral symmetry? In icosahedral, we have equilateral triangle. Can you see? There are 12 equilateral triangles. I can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 here and few are behind. So there are 12 equilateral triangles everywhere. Total, pura cover karte hue, us symmetry ko kehte hain icosahedral. It looks like diamond. It is looking like a diamond. That is icosahedral symmetry. The second is helical. Helical is like a screw. Helical. Can you appreciate? It is like a screw. This symmetry is helical. Aur icosahedral aur helical ko chhod ke kuch bhi hai. Remaining all. So it is known as complex. So we are having three types of symmetry. What are the three? First learn the name. Pehle naam bolo. Icosahedral, jisme we are having 12 equilateral triangles, right? Helical, in which it is screw shape, like this. And complex is remaining all. Na ye, to remaining all is complex, right? Now, my next question to you. You know the six DNA. Among the six DNA, which is having with symmetry? Which one is having with symmetry? And you know the 15 RNA. Among the 15 RNA, which one is having with symmetry? ठीक है, so you know that, you should answer that. So किसी को पता है क्या? Shall I proceed? You got my next point. So पहले तो तीन तरह की symmetry याद करो, तीनों के diagram याद करो. First learn the diagrams and the names of the three type of symmetry. Now let me first finish DNA. Among the DNA, there are six DNA ना? You know what are the six DNA? HHA, PPP. Among the six, last P को हटा दो. Last P is pox virus, the largest one. The remaining five are icosahedral. So all DNA are icosahedral except pox, which is complex. You got my point? What I am saying, all DNA are icosahedral. Give me a minute. Let me erase it and come again. Okay. So the page is empty, I guess, now, and we can go ahead. Okay. Among the DNA, can you see? So what is the summary among DNA? So all DNA are icosahedral except pox, which is complex. So 5 DNA, you know the name HHAPP, except POX, the POX one, the last P is the complex. So that is the summary of the DNA. Can I say none of the DNA is helical? If I say none of the DNA is helical, yes, I am right. None of the DNA is helical. So this is the summary of the DNA. Among the 6 DNA, all of them are icosahedral, only POX is complex, none of them is helical. I want thumbs up from all of you. If you got this, give me a thumbs up. So I will come on the RNA now. I will come on the RNA. Thumbs up do. Aditya, Priyanshi, Yogita, Amar, others, Osama, give me a thumbs up. Are you people there? Patafat, give me a thumbs up. So that is about the DNA. Among the RNA, we are having how many RNA? None of the RNA is complex. None of the RNA is complex. We are having 15 RNA. Among the 15, we divided them into 12:3. 12 were having envelope and 3 were naked. The 3 were naked, they don't have envelope. So the naked 3 RNA, the 3 RNA naked, you know which one? PCR. PCR are icosahedral. And remaining 12, which one? The enveloped one, they are helical. And none of the RNA is box. I cannot simplify more than this. The summary is written in front of you. You know, start with DNA. DNA se start karo. So there are 6 DNA. 6 mein se ek hata do. Kaun sa hata do ke? POX. POX ko de do complex. Complex सिर्फ एक ही होता है pox. दुनिया में only one virus is complex, that is pox. That's it. और उसके अलावा के 5 are icosahedral. तो helical को लग गया बुरा कि यार मुझे तो एक भी नहीं दिया. उस सारे तुमने उनमें बांट दिए दोनों में और मेरे को एक भी नहीं है. तो हमने जाके helical को कहा कोई बात नहीं. Among the RNA तो 12 रख ली. तेरे को उधर से नहीं मिला ना, तो यहां से हम तुझे 12 दे देंगे. तो विच 12? द एनवलप्ड वन. ऑल 12 आई विल गिव टू द हेलिकल एंड द रिमेनिंग 3 द नेकेड वन आई विल गिव टू आइकोसाहेड्रल. आई हैव लर्न लाइक दिस. छोटी छोटी स्टोरी बना के याद करो तो यू विल नेवर फॉरगेट, है ना. कॉन्सेप्ट से याद करोगे तो भूल जाओगे एग्जाम में. छोटी छोटी स्टोरी. तो डीएनए में हमने हेलिकल को एक भी नहीं दिया तो उसको बुरा लग गया कि यार डीएनए का तो मुझे एक भी नहीं दिया, तो आरएनए के 12 का लॉट उसको दे दो, है ना, कि कोई बात नहीं आरएनए का 12 तेरे, द एनवेलप्ड वन. सो दिस इज हाउ वी कैन लर्न इट. ठीक है. सो व्हाट इज द समरी वी हैव लर्न? द समरी इज रिटन इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. लर्न लाइक दैट. सो ऑल डीएनए वायरसेस आर आइकोसाहेड्रल एक्सेप्ट पॉक्स व्हिच इज कॉम्प्लेक्स. नन ऑफ द डीएनए इज हेलिकल. तो लगा उसे बुरा. ठीक है. तो ऑल आरएनए आर हेलिकल. द 12 आरएनए द विच वर एनवेलप्ड वन आर हेलिकल एंड द 3 नॉन एनवेलप्ड वन आर आइकोसाहेड्रल. यू गॉट माय पॉइंट? चलो समराइज करेंगे सिमेट्री. हु विल हेल्प मी इन द समरी ऑफ द सिमेट्री? कौन हेल्प करेगा सिमेट्री में? सिमेट्री में मुझे हेल्प करो, जो मैं पूछूं उतना बताओ. डीएनए एंड आरएनए, लेट मी राइट द 3 ऑप्शंस. आइकोसाहेड्रल, हेलिकल एंड कॉम्प्लेक्स. यहां पे भी लिखने दो, आइकोसाहेड्रल, हेलिकल एंड कॉम्प्लेक्स. तो मुझे बताओ इनमें से कौन कौन कौन, इनमें से कौन कौन कौन. यू टेल मी द आंसर्स. हु विल टेल मी? देयर आर 6 डीएनए. अमंग देम ओनली वन इज पॉक्स, दैट इज कॉम्प्लेक्स. एंड रिमेनिंग ऑल फाइव आर आइकोसाहेड्रल. नन इज हेलिकल. दिस इज माय समरी रिगार्डिंग द डीएनए. यू विल नेवर फॉरगेट. नाउ गिव मी अ थम्स अप. यस योगिता, एब्सोल्युटली राइट. प्रियांशी, एब्सोल्युटली राइट. वेरी गुड योगिता एंड प्रियांशी. व्हाट अबाउट अदर्स? बाकी लोग सो रहे हैं क्या? सब लोग रिप्लाई करो. एवरीवन, यस यस, वेरी गुड. यस आदित्य, वेरी गुड. अमंग द आरएनए हु विल टेल मी? नाउ हियर हेलिकल इज हैविंग नन ना. सो हेलिकल को वी विल गिव द 12 इनवॉल्व्ड आरएनए. द 12 इनवॉल्व्ड विल बी हेलिकल हियर एंड द 3 नॉन इनवॉल्व्ड, द 3 नेकेड वन, नॉन इनवॉल्व्ड वन, दैट इज पीसीआर, वी विल गिव हियर. वी विल गिव आइकोसाहेड्रल. नन ऑफ द आरएनए इज कॉम्प्लेक्स. So can I say 2 statements? None of the DNA is helical, none of the RNA is complex. Learn these 2 statements. So the things will become easy for you. Out of the 6, what is the distribution? It's 5:1. 5:1. And out of the RNA, 15 RNA, what is the distribution? It's 12:3 again. So you have to learn with symmetry. So it will become easy for you. The things will become easy for you. Very good, Amar. You got it? I guess everyone got it. So this is how, that is the summary of the symmetry of the virus. The last thing is the shape of the virus. Now every virus have a unique shape, right? But the important shapes on which maximum MCQs come in your exam, they are 4. You have to learn. Pox virus is brick shape. Brick ka matlab hota hai ईंट, you know, ईंट hota hai. So when I will teach you individual viruses na, I'm going to teach you all these viruses in detail. Ye to sirf general classification chal raha hai. Iske baad ek ek chapter hai virology mein. So I will show you the diagram. The pox virus is brick shape. The rabies virus is bullet shape. You know, bullet shape. Very, very, very important. It's bullet shape. Bahut baar PYQ hai. You have to learn. I will draw the diagram. Tobacco mosaic virus is rod shape. Rod. Rod ke jaisa hota hai. Lamba. Rod ke jaisa. And adenovirus is space vehicle shape. I forgot to put the diagrams here. I just forgot. So, you can Google the diagram, or when I will teach you individual chapters, I will show you the diagram. So, what is the summary? Today, we have learned the 4 things regarding the viruses. We have learned the structure of virus, you know. So the 2 things are compulsory. All viruses have nucleic acid, whether DNA or RNA. All have capsid, which is made up of capsomer. It is protein. But some have envelope, some do not have envelope. That is regarding structure we have learned. After that, we have learned in detail the classification of the viruses. So classification have to be done on multiple criteria. Classification has to be done on multiple criteria. The most important is the classification. So the most important is DNA and RNA. DNA kitne hain, RNA kitne hain, sabse pehli baat. DNA mein se enveloped kitne hain, non-enveloped kitne hain, RNA mein se enveloped kitne hain, non-enveloped kitne hain. DNA mein se smallest kaun hai, largest kaun hai, RNA mein se smallest kaun hai, largest kaun hai. DNA mein se single-stranded kaun hai, double-stranded kaun hai, RNA mein se single-stranded kaun hai, double-stranded kaun hai, RNA mein se fragmented aur non-fragmented bhi ek classification hai. So fragmented se bora hai, bache huye sab non-fragmented. So this is how the ways we are classifying the viruses. Pehle DNA, RNA, uske baad further. This is how we do the classification. You know the answers, the 6 viruses here and 15 here, never forget. After that, try to learn the members inside them. Give me a thumbs up. So that is all about the classification. Theek hai? Classification ke baad, we have seen the structure. We have seen the classification in detail. After that, I guess we have seen the symmetry. We are having 3 options. The icosahedral, helical and complex. Among the DNA, what is the distribution? Among the RNA, what is the distribution? Learn the symmetry, right? Or symmetry learn karne ke baad, we have seen the important shapes. So this completes the general structure and classification of the virus with multiple MCQs. You can't believe इस portion से कितने MCQs हैं. Now you all may be having some of the platform ना, where you may be following the MCQs practice. So please do the MCQ practice of this portion today only, and you will find your 100% questions will be correct and you are able to solve them from this portion. That is general virology का classification and structure of virus वाला portion, right? So still many important topics are still remaining in the general virology, that is replication, inclusion bodies and cultivation and lab diagnosis of the virus. These four headings are remaining in general virology. उसके बाद the chapter wise different viruses we have to study. This is how the way we study virology. When I teach virology, bacteriology or parasitology, now I am going to cover them according to the new syllabus in microbiology. So previously in microbiology, we have bacteriology, in which we compare all the bacteria, the various. So in your syllabus, nearly 30 or 40 bacteria were there. In the virology again, in the parasitology again, like this. But now it's not the organism wise, it's system wise. You know, you may be knowing your curriculum has changed now. So it's system wise. So we will take the GIT, all the bacteria which cause GIT infection, all the virus cause GIT infection, and all the parasites causing GIT infection. Then I will take the next system, that is CNS, the same. The bacteria causing CNS infection, the virus causing CNS infection, the parasites causing CNS infection. Then I will take respiratory system. In this way, I will take the important 7 systems are there. 7 to 8 systems are there. Ek-ek system leke padhenge. Lekin usse pehle approach kya hai? Tumhe pure bacteriology ka classification aana chahiye. Unme se kitne GI infection karate hain, kitne CNS karate hain, kitne respi karate hain, kitne endocrine karate hain. Wo ek-ek karke dekhenge. You got my point. Pure viruses ka classification aana chahiye. Ab unme se main kaun sa kis system mein dalungi, that we will see further. पूरी पैरासाइटों का क्लासिफिकेशन आना चाहिए. तो फर्स्ट थिंग फॉर द सिस्टम वाइज अप्रोच इज द क्लासिफिकेशन, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एंटायर बैक्टीरियोलॉजी, एंटायर वायरोलॉजी, एंटायर पैरासाइटोलॉजी. इफ यू नो द क्लासिफिकेशन, कितने बैक्टीरियाज हैं, कैसे क्लासिफाई करते हैं, क्राइटेरिया क्या है, कितने वायरसेस हैं, आज देख लिया. यू हैव सीन द 6+15 फैमिलीज, द 6 DNA एंड 15 RNA. यू नो द नेम्स ऑफ ऑल ऑफ देम. ठीक है, और पैरासाइट्स कितने हैं. सो टुमारो आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू, नॉट टुमारो, मे बी नेक्स्ट वीक आई विल टीच यू द कंप्लीट वायरोलॉजी, कंप्लीट पैरासाइटोलॉजी क्लासिफिकेशन. आफ्टर दैट वी विल टेक सिस्टम वाइज. सो पहले दिन मैंने ले लिया GIT, GIT में बैक्टीरिया कितने, वायरस कितने, पैरासाइट कितने. दूसरे दिन मैंने ले लिया CNS, कितने बैक्टीरिया, कितने वायरस, कितने पैरासाइट. सो इन दिस वे वी विल कंप्लीट द इंपॉर्टेंट 7 to 8 सिस्टम्स. दिस इज द अप्रोच ऑफ द न्यू कैरिकुलम. आर यू स्टडिंग विद द न्यू कैरिकुलम? Does the curriculum is changed in your college also? I'm talking about microbiology new curriculum. Give me a thumbs up. Yogita, Priyanshi, Amar, please answer. Yes? Osama, in your college, is the curriculum is changed from the organism wise to system wise? Is it changed? So we will study with the new curriculum only, right? So if you have any doubt, don't, yes, autocoils, mycology, I'm going to take all these topics, Priyanshi. It is already in their pipeline, they are scheduled. So week by week I will launch the schedule and I will take the important topics which are coming on huge demand throughout the country, right? So don't forget to ask your doubts. If you have any doubt, study related doubt regarding your university exam or your competitive exam, patho, pharma, micro, or any study related doubt, you are free to ask me on this contact number. So text me either on WhatsApp or on Telegram, right? So my contact number is 9833032948, right? So this is my contact number. Now in the comments of this video which you are watching right now, in the comments the first message is pinned message. In that pinned message, there is a link given. The link tree link is given. If you click on that link now, you can connect me on all social media. So you can connect me on the Facebook, you can connect me on the Instagram, you can connect me on the WhatsApp group link is given. You can add on the WhatsApp group, you can connect me on the Telegram. So you can connect me with all the social medias if you wish. So the link of that is given in the comments and it is already pinned. So try to connect me with all social media, so it will be helpful for you. I will share the study related free content on all these medias. Thank you very much for being with me. I really appreciate the time you people are giving me daily. And tomorrow again 9 AM in the morning we will meet live. We will meet live, and tomorrow I am teaching you the first DNA virus. The first, I will start with DNA virus. The first DNA virus I am going to teach you is pox virus. Pox virus, the smallpox virus, right? The largest DNA virus, the largest overall virus, we will study tomorrow completely. Don't dare to miss it. One more humble request I want to make you is to share the links and this information that every day ma'am comes live at 9 a.m. in the morning and she teach one important topic for the university exam of the second prof from Patho Pharma Micro. Please share this information on your batch groups. You are belonging to different colleges, I guess. So throughout the country, this information should be shared because the knowledge is free here, absolutely free. Everyone can get benefited. To your friends, colleagues, I must say any medico throughout the globe. If you have any contact, please share the link. The link of my Linktree you can share. So thank you very much. If you like the lecture, don't forget to click on the like button before you leave. Don't forget to share the link and please subscribe if you have not yet subscribed to our YouTube channel. And please press the bell icon for getting further notified. Thank you. See you. Bye-bye. Study hard and all the best. Okay. So I'm ending the session.